All right, first of all, hat goes off to Rick Connor and the Lancers of
Linganore.
Great game, great second half adjustments. I think they put 21 points on us at halftime, 21 or 22 in the second half. Great plan, great team, great program.
What was the biggest problem, Coach, in the second half that caused things to kind of fall apart?
Well, they got some big calls with the tight end. That was happening all game. I guess the refs were letting them play. You know, it's here, there, and they say whatever. Especially in the second half, the one with the running back, they called something on Kevin. They called something on 22 earlier when we were guarding him. And then their run game started popping a little bit. So that's what happened. Shout out to the community from Milford, the principal, the administration, all the people who came out. Thank you so much. I'm sorry I didn't bring it home, but you better believe I'm going to go back and try again, and I'm going harder.
You guys had an injury on the defensive line in the second half, did you not?
I mean, everybody was cramping. I don't think we had a major injury, no, not that I remember. We had a couple people cramp up. We had D. Woods cramp up, 22 cramped up. Our quarterback was going both ways, you know. Kevin played a hell of a game, 52-6, going both ways. Obasi going both ways. Troy was giving it his everything on every run. I mean, we played an excellent game.
On that final drive where you guys scored your last touchdown, there's about a little over four minutes left on the clock. Could you have melted more time off?
Well, in football, when you got a groove, you got to ride that groove, you know, so it's like a wave, and we had to just ride it, you know, hoping that the defense would battle. Like I said, they got penalties, man. I would love to see the penalty count. It was so off balance. I think I got two calls all night. I got a block in the back, and I got maybe one holding, or maybe two, maybe three calls the entire night, and that's tough. That's tough, and they got a bunch on us. And I know we're disciplined, and I know that discipline, and I shouldn't be saying this. It was a great game. Great game. That's all I want to say.
Coach, did you think that they were going to come out in the second half with different energy from the first?
Absolutely. Absolutely, and that's what I told those guys in the locker room. I said Coach O'Connor and over there and his staff are giving them one hell of a speech and making great adjustments. And we got the ball back, and we wanted to go down the score and withstand that first, that first coming out, especially offensively, our defense. And that's what we wanted to do. We expected that.
Talk about the offense. You guys had a lot of success in the first half. What were some things that you saw?
We threw the deep ball a lot, mm-hmm. and it backed up a whole bunch. So we tried to go with some underneath stuff, some quicks and things like that. I mean, shout out to Greg Trogdon, my OC. He's a genius over there. I trust him with everything, and he gets those guys in the best position and to do everything they need to do.
I thought a big momentum switch was them getting that touchdown right before the end of the half.
Yeah.
After, I think you guys had a third and short, and you gave the ball to Troy, and Troy lost 2 yards, and then you punted to him.
Yeah. They went no huddle. Mm-hmm. But I thought that no huddle was the same place. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I reviewed the film, but mm-hmm. I think they just sped up what they were doing. Mm-hmm. But we were stopping it early. I think our kids got a little anxious and started getting a little fitsy, and we got out of sorts. Didn't come in here expecting to shut them out by no source of imagination. But like I said, great game. Great game. If we had this quarterback boot right on the 25-30, he ran it for a first down, we stop him on that fourth down ball game. Different outcome. Yeah. Different outcome.
Were you close to going for it on a fourth and two around the 5-minute mark? You were touchdown before last. You guys were driving at third and short. You were close to going. How close were you?
I wanted to back him up, Alex, to be for real. I think I'm remembering exactly what you're talking about, but I wanted to back them up and make sure that they had to drive the length of the field.
Coach, I want to comment, something that gets overlooked, especially on the high school level, is how you manage these teenagers. And, in a moment like this, after they lost, it's hard for them to control their emotions. I heard you say it to your guys, I know it hurt. What do you do to make sure that you keep them composed? And two, how important is that for you?
Well, as the leader of this team, the first thing I got to do is set the example and set the bar high. And I got to teach them that in life, not just in football, in life there's going to be ups and downs. We're going to have significant losses in our life from family. We might have a job or two we lose or things like that, accidents, anything could happen. And it's just, we can't be too low and too high. And it's hurting, because I'm hurting for all 48 of my kids. I'm hurting for my coaches. I'm hurting for a lot of people. I put a lot of people on my shoulder. And it's tough, man. It's tough. But they good, man. They resilient, man. They resilient. They resilient. They going to college. They coming back, These three are gone. He's gone. These two are coming back. We're going to be back, man. I'm excited in the midst of this pain.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, talk about what all you accomplished, Coach, this year. I mean, getting to the first state finals in 30 years since you were playing. Man. I mean, winning the county championship. There's so much. I know the pain is great right now, yeah. But when you think about it, there's a lot of joy for what you guys have accomplished.
My biggest thing, man, is, Derek, it's just that I hope that at the end of the day, we shed some great light on Milford Mill. It's not about me. It's not about these players. I mean, I'm glad they did what they did for themselves. We can bang with the big boys. We can do it right. It's not all bad over there.
For the seniors, just talk about just the experience of getting to the state finals and all you guys went through.
He was led by our seniors, Nick, me, Troy Scott, and Glenn Tavis. And we also had a junior leading us too. So, it was great, We felt as though we had all the pieces we needed to accomplish what we right here. So, we had the chance, we took it and then we let it go. So, at the end of the day, that's on us, not on the coaches. What am I playing?
Brandon.
Talk a little bit about that second half, Luka. It seemed like when they punched you at the end of the first half, you didn't quite come back with the the oomph that you had earlier in the first half. It took you a little while to get that back.
Yeah, well, first of all, we're just going to talk about how Coach White pointed out the fact that their head coach gave them a good speech. They was going to come out ready, but they was going to come out fired up, Nobody's going to hand us anything. So they came out fired up, and we just came out like we had a 19-0 lead. So, that's exactly what happened. They hit us in the mouth. The run game started popping, just like he said. They just caught some really good plays. That boot was a really good call. Wasn't expecting it, so some good play calling.
Talk about getting the team to come back. You guys were down 22-19. I don't know what the score, but you guys got off the mat. Regain the lead. Just kind of talk about that resilience you guys showed.
During the timeout, I gave the team a little sideline speech. I told them it's not over. We've been down a lot of times this season, and as you see, we came back. We fought hard, and this time we just didn't come out with the outcome that we expected. So hopefully next year they can regroup and bring it back home next year.
All right, Coach. Thank you all.
Thank you, guys. I appreciate y'all. Appreciate all y'all support all year, man.
Thanks, Richard.